I'm gonna give you this, man. I'm starting to get pissed off now, bro.
Why?
I mean, they really put me to the test. I mean, give this young man a chance. He had bull crap out there with him on the field. He had the worst offensive line in the NFL in front of him, and yet he was still able to go out there and beat the Saints. Now, yeah. Say what you want to say. Give the young man an opportunity to at least go out there and show you that he can play. He's doing all the right things in the offseason. He's out, you know, politicking and doing whatever he can to gain support of not just this city, but to the players on this team. He's going up and have catches with guys. Come on, man. I'm sorry.
Come on, Aish.
Barrett Brooks is in the house. Barrett Brooks. Barrett Brooks is here.
Yeah, that's the bar can.
Barrett Brooks is here. Oh my God! It might be one of those days. I got no idea.
Yeah. And Mr. Diddy.
Nobody made Eddie Barkowitz sound more important than bar can.
Eddie B is here.
Right. Oh man!
So
like, wow.
Yeah, you're right. You're right. I mean, there was that cell. You had to stick around and watch no matter what because you thought Eddie Barkowitz was going to drop some heavy bomb B-52
on Daily News Live.
Yep. Go yes, full sir. Love Shack on you. How about that?
Man, but I tell you what, though, man, he's the best at making you feel like you're a lot more than what you are, bro.
Him and Angelo Cataldi.
Right.
Well, I was thinking that in my head, like, who has a bigger sell? Is it Cataldi for our own on Philly Voice, of course, Kevin Cooney?
Yeah.
Who gets the biggest sell ever on anybody?
I mean, he's like Nobel Peace Prize winning.
I'm like, wait a second. Have I been underselling Kevin Cooney this whole time? Like, I've been reading bios and setting him up as one of the savviest baseball writers and minds we have in the city. And Cataldi's making me think, like, wait, what did I miss?
Right.
Barkin on the other side. We got Barrett Brooks! He sounds like Regis.
Regis, that's what I was just thinking.
Yeah, maybe that's
same page today. Uh-oh, yeah, look
that's
out.
A problem. Barrett, you better keep up.
That is
man, I'm already strapped up, baby. Strapped up.
Yeah, I've been going since early this morning. We did the podcast this morning at 8 o'clock, and then I did Birds 360.
65?
Yep.
Yeah.
920. It went well.
How did the interaction with you and John McMullen about calling him out, because I'm sure you did, even on their own show, because you have no shame.
Right.
None whatsoever.
Well, he actually brought it up. He actually broached the subject.
Well, he tried to preempt it.
Yeah, he wanted to preempt it, and I told him, I said, yeah, I ripped you yesterday, but I rip, and then I move on.
Right.
Yeah. I don't dwell on it.
That moving hand that writes, after it writes, it moves on, man.
That's
it's got to go, you know what I'm saying?
That's right.
Well, Harry subscribes to the old law of Confucius.
Which
is to forgive but not forget is to not forgive.
Right.
So Harry forgives, he forgets, he moves on, and you see him a year later. I don't even, who are you again?
Right.
He'll give you those De Niro squints.
Yeah.
Who are you again? Now, he doesn't talk like De Niro, just gives you that little squint. Who are you again?
Yeah. I need a little Havlicek today, man.
Well, but I praised Barrett on Birds 365 today.
You did.
I praised him for being a hell of a teammate because he passed on the NFL alumni golf outing because we couldn't do the show out there.
Right.
Really?
So, yeah.
And they got all kind of free stuff too, bro. I just want to let you guys know. But hey, my boy dropped off.
What do you mean?
Locked and loaded.
Look at this. Would you get a box?
Yes, sir.
What are they?
This is a special blend that this company.
Ohiva?
Yeah, it's a company around here that made a special blend. Like this has like, you know, not just the tobacco itself, but also has a hint of lavender in it. Not lavender, but what is it? Vanilla.
But is that a Percocet in it,
dude? You just don't know.
The boss lady be smoking that cigar pretty soon.
Amazing, man. Rocking and rolling.
Oh. Hey, what did you say?
Huh? Did you guys see this thing real quick on Philly Voice? Matt Mullen actually had it out here. The headline is what they're saying. Eagles tried to trade up for a cornerback or quarterback before drafting Devontae Smith. Now, we already had that report that came out about Wilson early in the offseason, but Jeremy Fowler says Eagles were eyeing a quarterback or quarterback at ESPN. Mm-hmm. And I'll read you the quotes here.
I believe it.
In typical fashion, Eagles were all over the map in the hours before the draft. Howie Roseman loves to mix it up with trade talk. He'll go down. He'll go sideways. Should I do it, Regis? He'll go up. He'll go down and sideways on the pod. I talked to three different. We got time. I talked to three different high-ranking execs in the numbers 5 through 15 range who said A, the Eagles were trying to move up, and B, they were eyeing a quarterback, most likely, or possibly, a quarterback. Mm-hmm. There you go.
I'm gonna give you this, man. I'm starting to get pissed off now, bro.
Why?
I mean, they're really putting me to the test. I mean, give this young man a chance. He had bull crap out there with him on the field. He had the worst offensive line in the NFL in front of him, and yet he was still able to go out there and beat the Saints. Now, say what you want to say. Give the young man an opportunity to at least go out there and show you that he can play. He's doing all the right things in the offseason. He's out, politicking and doing whatever he can to gain support of not just this city, but to the players on this team. He's going up to have catches with guys. Come on, man. I'm starting. I'll finish this after this right now.
Thank you, sir.
In partnership with Jacob Media.
By the way.
Joey B. Her Yoki, yep.
Wizard killed me.
Starts now on the Sportsmax Radio Network. Not.
Presented by Rocket Mortgage. Home loans that fit your life. Rocket can.
From the O'Reilly Auto Parts Studios, here's Eitan Shander, Barrett Brooks, and Harry Mays.
All right, we welcome you in the midday part of the week here on the middle for you. And Harry Mays already been up and running. This is his third appearance at the very least, if not show, and Barrett is already up. He's fixed 1.5 cars at 5:30 in the morning.
Welded a motor already, I think.
I'm trying to TIG weld. It is really starting to piss me off that I can't just, it takes me a little while, to do the impossible.
TIG weld, yeah.
TIG weld, yeah.
Oh, I thought you said Rod Tidwell.
Go ahead. TIG weld, man. Yeah.
But it's a lot harder than what I thought, man. It's a lot that goes into it. But hey, I enjoy doing it. It took me a day and a half to learn how to MIG weld. Well, it's probably going on 3 or 4 days learning the arts of TIG welding.
So it's MIG versus TIG.
Yeah, MIG versus TIG.
Wow.
And it's easier to MIG weld. Mm. TIG weld gives you a better product, but it's harder. Like to put it in financial terms. If you're a MIG welder, you make some good money. But if you're a TIG welder, multiply it by 3, and that's how much you get paid to be a TIG welder.
Man, you're going to get paid for all this welding?
I don't have to pay somebody to do it. Like it's almost like maybe $100 for 6 inches of
that sounded bad. I just want to let you know that the stream is going to go crazy with that.
Is that the street rate, by the way?
Yeah. Right. Wow. But just to put it in terms, people charge a lot to TIG weld, man.
Man, that's inflation. 6 inches cost you $100 now, man.
You're going to the wrong guy or whoever you may be going to.
Back in the day, you could get that for $40.
And a little extra, if you know what I'm saying. Huh?
Exactly right.
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, man.
Oh, boy. Wow. I knew today was going to be special.
Wow.
Hey, look, look at Muhammad Ali. He understands, too. Just $100 for 6 inches?
Yeah.
I mean, that's my rate. That's like a rate that people – that's an Eagles fan would give me.
Right.
But it's a lot more expensive than that, man. It's very expensive, bro.
So what you're saying is that for all those people out there that want to become broadcasters.
Hold on, real quick. We're back in 3 on the network. Go ahead, Aaron.
For all you're giving a public service message for all those younger people that want to become Eitan Shanders and Harry Mays's to go to Votech school and learn how to TIG weld and make yourself a career, and you'll always have a job and you'll make good money.
Go out and be a welder, man.
Yeah.
You can get that money.
You're better off trying to invent something like this.
Nutri-Grain Bites.
Seriously.
Well, no, you love the snacks, hub. Man. You are a snackaholic.
And create something like this. They make Pop-Tarts in minis now, too.
They do?
Everything's in bites. It's minis. It's small.
Yeah, the only problem with that is then you eat 40 of them.
Well, I mean, that's the
problem.
Bag.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's the problem. Absolutely. See, that's why I go. I forget going with the little. I always go with the economy size, the big size.
Oh, yeah, the fun size?
Whatever I do big. You know what I mean? I do big. Look at I'm not this. Trying to get that small.
The cheese stuff, balls. Oh, yeah. My God.
You got to go big, man. You know what I'm saying? And this from my. And it was free from my boys at Hertz. You know what I'm saying? They hooked me up, bro.
That looks like as big as the container for my cholesterol medication. Jeez.
Let me see that one more time.
Cheese balls.
No, I know. So this there reminds me. Yeah.
Now, wow. See, this is my head. It's bigger than my head. Bro.
It is. So, yeah, it is.
But it's a lot of cheese balls.
So there was a rumor, which I could neither confirm nor deny, that G. Cobb would have a little trouble staying up on the overnight shift. Right?
Yeah, I heard that too.
Right. So I would produce that shift every now and again with G.
Yeah.
A fantastic dude.
He's great.
Nicest human beings you'll meet. And at one point, he was like, man, I'm struggling. I'm like, just tell him that. Right. So we were going back and forth, and I kept coming in the break, you know, trying to talk with him because I was struggling too. I mean, look, I'm not wide awake, fired up at 2:30 in the morning either. So next week, and then for the next 3 or 4 weeks that I worked with him, this dude, I love him for it too. He came in with one of those, it made a Costco-sized bag of popcorn look small. Like, it came up to his weight. This dude played linebacker in the NFL, and it came up to, like, his mid. It was this gigantic child size, and I don't mean, like, for eating a child. I mean the size of, like, a 13-year-old. And, man, he just kept munching and munching at every break, a couple of pieces at a time just to keep him going, man. Mm-hmm. It was like he was popping popcorn. It was hilarious.
You got to do whatever it takes to stay up, man.
Yep. Wow. Yep. Whatever. Hey, man, I'm coming there too and say, hey, can I get a little cup here? Popcorn keep you awake. It's a great little thing, man.
Less filling,
life
though.
Life size.
So well, I have a feeling that Eitan's round robin did not go too well last night.
I'm still alive.
You are? Okay, because you got games tonight. Yeah. The NBA games tonight.
But we crushed it on the first quarter at first half for the Pacers game.
This is The Middle on the Sports Map Radio Network.
Presented by Rocket Mortgage.
Live from the O'Reilly Auto Parts Studios, here's Eitan Shander, Barrett Brooks, and Harry Mays.
So we do know here in Philadelphia who, in fact, the Sixers will be playing. It's going to be one of two teams. Because for some reason, the Washington Wizards, you want to talk about height in the story that I just told. For some reason, the Washington Wizards did not put anybody that was taller than that bag of popcorn G. Cobb had on Jason Tatum. And I don't think at any point in the night did he have a hand, not in his face, but like up contesting his hand.
Right.
I don't understand it. Washington refused to put anybody taller on Tatum. He drops 50. That's the play, and that killed me across the board. Made it up because Harry asked on the Pacers. We crushed it. First quarter Pacers, first half Pacers, first half total points Pacers, and there was one other that we got in there. First quarter total over because the Pacers scored points.
Go ahead.
No, I was just going to say it's going to be one of the two. That was it.
Okay. Well, good. At least we're narrowing it down. But I am of the mindset watching that game last night that the Washington Wizards tanked that game.
They had no
interest in advancing in the playoffs, knowing that they were going nowhere. And Westbrook and Beal combined for 1 for 10 from 3-point range and 7 turnovers. They were both awful.
Yes, awful.
They didn't care. They didn't want to guard Tatum. Tatum went off, and the Wizards were content to just go home.
You sent that text, man.
Yeah. And then I really started looking at it, and you could just tell collectively as a unit, man, nobody wanted any parts of them. Mm-hmm. You know, nobody wanted to guard them. And at the end of the day, if you want to be that dude, you want to be that player, you go out there, you stick the guy, you shut him down.
Yeah.
See, I love it because at this point, I know that we'll just blow out the Celtics because they have nothing. They have nothing down low that could stop Embiid. But I really do know that if you put Ben on him, he can shut all that down. So I think that's a cakewalk to get through and beat up on the Celtics, man. I mean, it'll be easy. So we get him at what? We might get him in the second round?
No, it would be a first round.
The first round?
First second round's going to be the Knicks or the Hawks.
Okay.
Yeah, most likely the Knicks.
So, I mean, it'd be a great stroll through the park playing against the Celtics. Because they weren't even trying to win in the first half.
Yeah.
They weren't even putting forth an effort.
Yeah.
And they still could, and the Wizards still couldn't pull away from them. They had no interest in winning the first half of that game. None whatsoever.
Right. Now the Wizards have another chance Thursday night, tomorrow night. They have to win their game in order to make it. I don't think they're going to have any interest.
No.
Oh, and look, Boston right now without Jaylen Brown is not going to beat the Sixers. But what you don't want is all of a sudden Marcus Smart to be able to lock down and take out a Green or Curry to where you don't have those guys even available as far as like scoring. One bad game from Tobias Harris where he's hassled. Now Tatum, Simmons, and Tatum, like that's a thing where you have to win that battle. And
you got too much for them. Too much.
No, I'm saying, look, it's not about beating them in the series. What I'm saying is that you don't want to let a team like this hang around to where you're beating them in six.
Right.
Playing down as we've seen them playing down.
Yeah. Like,
that's what I'm trying to avoid. That's the only thing I'm trying to avoid, Barrett, is in this going to six. There's not losing to the Boston Celtics, but
no question.
I don't know, man. Like, you got to beat them. And I know this is, but you cannot afford to lose a single second, let alone a game at home, man. Not to this bad Boston team. But if they play down, we've seen it.
I can't see them playing down, especially, you know, the way things are.
They played down all year. What do you mean?
Well, this is different. They played all that to do all that to get to the number one seed. And now they're in the playoffs. This is why they did everything they, you know, to get to this point, to get into the playoffs. You know, say what you want to say as far as, you know, time management with Embiid and whatnot. If everything comes to this point, this is where we're going to see who this Sixers team really is in the playoffs. They feel slighted from you know, the last second shot, you know, 2 years ago.
Yeah.
Now they're at a point now they're ready to play. They're ready to compete.
And Embiid not getting the MVP, and you know, who knows what happens with Ben Simmons and his personal award pursuits, you know. So Doc Rivers, coach of the year. No, he's not gonna win that. So I mean, you know, maybe they use that as a little bit of an axe to grind.
Oh, man.
Yes.
Come on.
Yes.
What?
You know, these guys sound like the Simpsons episode where both boxers were dedicating the fight to one of their former trainers who died. And then they get into the fight because they're both going back and forth on the same dedication here. Like, this is a manufactured. They shouldn't need motivation.
Well, I agree. They shouldn't need it, but you know, I'm giving it to them anyway.
Right.
And here's the thing. We've seen the opposite.
And you didn't hate to give it to them either.
No, I did not.
No, we've seen the opposite consistently where they played down.
Well, it has a difference.
I'm just giving them the benefit that they've earned.
Right.
That's all.
Right, right. But
you're the eternal optimist.
I have to be. I have to be.
No, like you
I
said, don't. You
know? Yes, I do, cool. man.
Is that in your contract? Is that thing to the Jacob
is that,
Media?
Is that a Jacob Media thing? Is there a paragraph in the contract that I missed?
Seriously. No, what it is I gotta keep you two afloat. I gotta equalize everything, man. I have to make sure that the show's not brought down every single week. You know what I'm saying? Because you guys have people ready to jump off the Walt Whitman Bridge. You know, if you listen to you guys for a minute, but no, seriously.
I'm talking about too much Latifah.
Yeah.
Well, man, realistically.
Yes.
This is a good Sixers team, regardless of playing down and yada, 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 yada. They're at a point right now that I believe that they're going into the playoffs thinking, all right, we're the number one seed. We're the number one team in the East. We're going to start playing like it. We got to perform like it.
Well, they
I don't
want to
hear all the talk and everything.
They've got a wide open freeway to the Eastern Conference Finals. Okay. Absolutely. And then they got to take care of business and get to the West, you know, the NBA finals. And I think they will. I really do. I think this is the year they go to the I don't know if they win it, but I think they get to the finals.
Right now, their eyes are looking at what's going on in the West because they truly believe that they're going West. They truly believe.
Well, they can't look ahead though. We can.
Yeah, we can. That's what
yeah.
That,
yeah.
They but can. You know, this is why you play the game, man. This is to get to this point. There's no more excuses. We're going to cuss out Embiid. Yeah. We're going to cuss out Simmons if they don't make it now. Yes, they have to. We're the number one seed.
We need to send Barrett into that locker room, into that dressing room prior to game one so he can get into Ben Simmons' grill.
I would have them want to eat their young. They'd be chewing on all kind of gunpowder and drinking hot sauce.
Take some of them cheese balls in with you.
Right, yeah, no. That's it. Start pelting people with cheese balls.
I said, down! Get your ass up! If you can't get up for this, then get for this!
Right.
Put them around.
You talking about regular season? Yeah. We're talking about the regular season. We're in the playoffs now. Let's go, man.
Right.
Let's go.
Go in there and pull a Jim Mora.
Bro, I am so playoffs. Ready. Yeah, right. Yeah, man.
But did you see this other thing that came out regarding the Eagles?
Oh, no.
Yeah, because the guys on Birds 365 were diving into this. Pro Not football the fact that focus.
Trying to trade up for a quarterback or.
No. Pro Football Focus put out a list of the 32 quarterbacks and ranked them. Can you guess where Jalen Hurts is in the rankings?
What? This is the National Enquirer, by the way, of football stuff. Why do we keep giving them any type of credibility?
Well, they come out with content.
Not for me. I hate it. I hate them. I hate PFF. How do you hate it?
I can't hate them because they're a part of the sister country company that I'm with, man. But
no, there's nothing wrong with the company or them. Like, I don't hate the people who work there. Or I just
Collinsworth owns it, doesn't he?
Yeah, and I don't hate him. I love him, but I hate the idea of PFF. I hate every single second of the idea of PFF.
You got a lot of hate. I know.
Well, because he's 31st on a list, and it makes no sense because of the sample size is ridiculously small. And they put Carson Wentz like in the middle of the list.
Well, they got guys with no sample size ahead of them.
Yeah, they want everybody here to go crazy. Oh my!
There lies the problem. They know we're gonna get fired up. They know we're gonna feed right into it, and I'm right there feeding right into it.
Why? You know what they want from you. Why? They're asking for your money.
I love it. I love it. Because that's what makes guys like myself, Jalen Hurts. This is what drives you to be the best you can be. You know what I'm saying? I was told, no, you can't play football. You know, you're big, but you got asthma. You can't do this, you can't do that. I love that. 12-year NFL season later, a Super Bowl ring later, and now talking about football, you can't tell me nothing. Right. And that's what Hurts is doing right now. He's in a mindset, okay, then, if everybody is thinking this, I'm going to go out there and ball. Just like you guys said, everywhere he's went, he's had success.
That's what they told everywhere. Me, too, Barrett. You're a medical salesperson. Yeah. Get back in the operating room, you dope. You're not going to talk sports on the radio. What are you, crazy?
Right, exactly. See, look at you. You know what I mean? I mean, get your scrubs on
and go sell something.
Go out there and make $250,000. Instead, you want to come back here and make what?
Yeah, $25.
Yeah, exactly that. $25. Unbelievable, isn't it?
Yep.
But, man, realistically, man, this is what you want, man. This is exactly why you do it. This is why you play the game. So all your doubters – I bet you he's getting up like I did.
Okay.
Just one thing. So
Sirianni is papering the freaking walls with the PFF rankings. Is that what you're saying in the quarterback room? Is that what he's going to do?
As soon as they use that little flick and the key opens and they open the door, there's going to be a sign sitting right there that Jalen Hurts is going to see.
Right.
Number 31 ranked quarterback.
Yeah,
that's what he's going to see.
Jeffrey Lurie ought to buy a billboard right outside of the Novacare complex.
Exactly. He's going to be so fired up. And as an offensive lineman, you're fired up too, man. He's going to do every little thing he can. He's going to go to every quarterback whispering. He's going to do whatever it takes to become the best quarterback he can be. Because at this point, he has nobody on his side. If everybody's doubting him, that's what you want, man. That's the driving force. I can remember, man, when I was playing. It's like my 10th, 11th year in the league. And I would get my butt up at 3 o'clock in the morning and go run 2 miles just because I knew nobody else in my hemisphere was working out for an NFL team trying to make a team. Because I knew I had to do the little things to make sure that I, you know.
Were you listening to Big Daddy Graham overnights when you were doing that run at 3 in the morning?
Man. Probably Big Daddy Kane.
Yeah.
Well, back then it was like Ike was back then. You know what I mean? Ike was late.
Ike at night.
He was just starting out.
Yeah.
Yeah, the Ike and Ike show. That was I did a couple of updates on that shift.
See, man, so you got to use those type of things, man. Well, and I love it.
When I saw this list, or I didn't see it, but when I was told about it, I've since seen it. But my first question to McMullen and Jody Mack was, who's 32? If Jalen Hurts is 31, I got to know who 32 is.
You ain't never lie.
I don't care about number one, two, or three. Give me number 32. It was Drew Lock.
Right.
Drew Lock from Denver.
Right. Yeah. That's right.
Real quick, how did we get on Boston when I told you that they were going to play either Indiana or Washington? Because Ryan Rothstein hit me with a DM to remind, we got off this crazy track here, and it wasn't for me checking this clip that I'm going to play in the break from David Culley, which I'm about to call out as, if not a liar, because I don't want to be held liable here, but if not that, then someone who is misleading the media. Mm. We have another example of a professional coach, in this case in Houston, caught red-handed, in my opinion, misleading the media. And this is huge. Mm. This is a situation down there in Houston that we need to get to the bottom of, no?
I got a vested interest in Houston.
Yeah.
Yes, and look, I'm not talking about Deshaun Watson. I'm talking about Culley's eating habits.
Oh, okay.
We're going to get to that. Coming.
Right. Is he a cheese ballman?
No. He is a man who lied, and we're going to need Ron Culver on this too, so we can't do this in the break.
Come on, Double N.
Across the board here. The Jacob Media YouTube page. See people filing in as you are. Like, subscribe, hit the notification bell. We want to make sure that you don't miss a show here on the Jacob Media platform, from Birds 365 to the middle to the NFL show. Across the board, we have content with Gunner and other people popping up for special shows and just throughout the day with clips. You don't want to miss anything. That's why you want to like
and Rothstein's show.
Importantly, subscribe. Yes, sir.
And Rothstein's show.
Yes. Well, I'm saying exactly right. Ryan's show on the Jacob Media YouTube page as well. So we've got a bunch of stuff up there. We're also here on Sports Map Radio, where we're going to need Ron Culver's help to decipher something coming up, because I smell a rat.
Uh-oh.
Yep. All right. It's the middle. A lot happening here. Brooks, Mays, and Eitan back in three.
If you missed any of today's show on the Jacob Media channel, listen to the podcast on your way home. Available on YouTube, Apple, and Spotify.